Can't you
see how this would appear somehow ludicrous in the minds of a viewer watching that APC, which is the ruling party in the country, which has for the last 3 years plus held majorities in both chambers of the National Assembly, which confirmed these appointments and forwarded these appointments from the executive that's obviously led by the APC, that this same party that brought these people to where they are, you're now saying that an official appointed by the party is working actively against the party. Does it not appear funny to you at all?
First and foremost, it is wrong to assume that an INEC official is an official appointed by the party. But that's second. It brings us to the next point that we've been saying, that those who have been leading the National Assembly, the Senate, we are just persons who are not members of the APC, after all. That's the complaint of the party. We had the Senate president who was wearing the cloth of APC, but he was acting the script of the PDP. So it's possible that some of those things could pass.
For me, very clearly, I don't want to be dragged into the argument of what the rec did and the propriety in law of the kind of decision he ought to have taken. As far as we are concerned, circumstances on ground, the report from independent observers, and indeed the INEC, point clearly to the fact that the APC today in River State is preparing for a naming ceremony for a child, a pregnancy that had been aborted by virtue of failure of that election. That is not the issue for today.
Even though it's not completed.
There's just nothing to stand. There's nothing to stand on the basis of which anybody can begin to place validity on the result they are releasing from their camp. But that's not the issue for today. The issue for today is very simple, because if you don't resolve it well, you have a situation where the APC and the police are now constituting themselves into the electorate. They are the ones who determine who wins election in River State. And if this trend is allowed to stay, it will be exported to other parts of the country.
No, Honorable Commissioner, I want us to be fair to the truth, because when you talk about the political history of River State since 1999, we have seen a steady history of violence in elections, a steady history of election rigging. So when you say that it's just in recent times, it's difficult to now call into question the credibility of, say, this election without calling into question the credibility of the 2015 election, which threw your party up in the state.
Is that not even the more reason why you should be a lot more circumspect in dealing with the present situation? If you have had a checkered history of election in River State since 1999, like you said, should that not call for us to be a lot more serious and careful when we are dealing with electionary? I'm saying that regarding Saturday's election, the situation was avoidable. If you know that the political parties have the, for instance, going by your word, have the propensity to interfere with the electionary process, what did you do? I am saying that the police cannot begin to give a particular political party an advantage over
can I come in on that, please?
The SAS has been doing just that. But before I round up, he was talking about the factional chairman of APC, the gentleman, and all that. This is the same person facing multiple murder trial in River State. He mentioned the case here. This young man was granted bail by the Court of Appeal. I don't know whether you remember at some point when the special panel was being said to come and consider his bail application in Port Harcourt. I'm replying him. So he took bail and left.
And left.
The court has been looking for him.
And left. Look at how ridiculous this is.
The court in October 2017 issued a warrant of arrest against this same person.
Look at how ridiculous
this is. And this same person has remained elusive, and the police have refused to bring him to answer to his trial. I concede his right of innocence as stated in the constitution. But the point we are making: why is the police moving in the same convoy with the same person,
gentlemen,
that they ought to return to court for trial?
There's a serious issue that both INEC has raised here.
Yeah.
Because yes, it's important we have elections, but it has to be done in a peaceful environment so that no lives
and within are the confines
endangered
of the law
or lost. Now, INEC says, I mean, reading their accounts where they say a member of staff had their leg broken, a core member was stabbed twice, and it went on and on. Some of them, Mr. Mike Iginni, who incidentally at the time was the one representing the supervising commissioner, Mrs. Mia Bamuche, to supervise that election, said he saw politicians who were moving, he used the word platoon, with security agencies.
Sure.
That is a serious issue that, look, the country should not be allowed to happen. But we kind of asked them, look, which security agencies are these ones?
Yes.
So the police themselves, I said, look, we did not aid and abet any such thing.
Okay.
But aren't we concerned? Shouldn't we be concerned that, look, if people's lives are in danger because of this particular election, which is not even as big as the other elections, like the governorship or federal houses, shouldn't we be concerned to say, look, in the circumstance, should we have proceeded with the elections? You said we should have proceeded, even in the face of all of this that the INEC
has raised. That's not what INEC said. First and foremost, let me make the point clear.
Mike Ginny didn't say.
No. He didn't say that the threat was there before the election proceeded. He said in course of the election.
So while the election continued, there were those threats.
So I'll get back to that, but let me just start from historically. You see, when it comes to the violence in River State, APC has always been very concerned about it. And we have spoken out about it, against it, several times. If you remember in the rerun election in 2016, the governor of the state, in fact, practically gave out issuing death threats to electoral officers who were coming to the state to conduct the election. If you will not do this, you will be killed. If you will not do this, you will be killed, and all that and all that. He said all that on national television. APC was against it. APC had always been against it. APC will remain against it, even till tomorrow. Now, the point, what we're saying is this. Even when APC has said, we are going to man our votes, we are going to protect our votes, we would not allow a repeat of what happened, where the government will, where the governor will come with miscreants to disrupt the election, and then APC will just sit back. No, we won't do that.
Yeah, have both parties now demanded of police to find out who are those security agencies that they say were aiding and abetting politicians moving in platoon? None of them were reined in. Have both parties said, listen, that cannot continue to happen in the state?
Both parties have said so, and I have named names. He is always saying, oh, Assas. Okay, let us assume that both of us have named names. I have said that the chief security officer to the governor led a platoon of policemen from government house who are not supposed, who are special unit policemen who are supposed to be guiding the government house to election. I have made that allegation. He has also made an allegation to say that it is SARS that did it. Now, both of us have made allegation. It is for the police authority to carry out investigation. And I've also told you that the CSO, the governor, shot his pistol. These are things that police should find out. For us in the APC, we have always said that violence is not, election is not war. Election is supposed to be peaceful.
Okay,
but we will not allow PDP to continue in that impunity where they will come with violence and scare our people. We won't allow that.
Now, the point I'm making is very, I'm not making an allegation about SARS. We have pictorial evidence, we have video evidence, and it's trending, it's everywhere. I'm surprised you haven't shown it, but even the point that you have showed, did those ones look like government house police people?
That's the armored vehicle. That is the armored vehicle. That is the armored vehicle that's
whether you
in
want
front
to establish
government
it
house.
From my testimony or not. Get it very, very clear that if SARS is not stopped from doing what they are doing in River State, they will constitute themselves into the electorate that will determine who holds office in River State in connivance with the APC.
Chamberlain,
that is the position.
Chamberlain, just one last thing. Play that video and you will see that the APC vehicle, the armored personnel carrier vehicle that just drove past, is the one that is stationed in front of the government house.
An important point I will make before you go on break.
SARS doesn't
in
use
In Egede Street, five Hilux trucks used by the same factional chairman with the APC people were impounded. They are now in the police station. Those five trucks belong to the IG monitoring team in Bonoki. That's where they brought them from. The reason why they were able to impound them is that I told you that that place where they went to is a cluster of nine voting points put together. So hearing what was happening in other voting units, the people got prepared and got ready for them. When they got there, they confronted Chinyerigwe. Chinyerigwe spoke with the factional chairman of the APC, pleaded with him to allow peace to reign. While they were still talking, Chinyerigwe offered him beer, and while he was drinking, the men started jumping from the fence and went to the guy, started disrupting the place.
All right,
people now
gentlemen,
stopped the vehicles.
We'll come back to moving. This and take a look at it. We need to have peaceful elections, above all, no matter what happens. But we'll focus on that when we come back in a moment. Join us again.